Und es geht wieder weiter mit Kapitel Nummer 5 von Whisperer in Darkness. Das letzte Mal hat der Akeley sich mehr oder weniger per E-Mail verabschiedet und denkt, dass die Migos ihn demnächst holen kommen. Jetzt schauen wir mal, wie es weitergeht. 2 days after reading Akeley's frantic last email, I received another one, which was altogether shocking in its reversal of the sentiments which had characterized each of Akeley's past communications. Und ich darf wieder rumlaufen. Meine Güte. Was ist eigentlich, wenn ich hier zur Tür gehe? Nix, okay. Wilmarth, I must confess that I was entirely mistaken in my silly estimation of the Migos as our enemies. So much has changed in the last 2 days. We were correct in our speculations of the creature's existence and identity, but in believing they were malicious, we could not have been further from the truth. I already told you the aliens had attempted to communicate with me. Last night I finally listened to what they had to say and allowed a human messenger of theirs to enter my home and explain their true intentions. Everything humans have ever conjectured of these things, from my own previous theories to the old cycles of folklore, has been far off the mark. Our cultural and psychological constraints make us humans simply unable to grasp the full force of their thought processes unaided. What I thought was morbid and evil is in reality fantastic, mind-expanding and even glorious, bringing to me a spiritual sensation which previously we might have mocked like any naked delusion of human religious faith. It is simply the human tendency, a silly evolutionary feature having yet to be discarded, to shun the new and the different. Now I regret harming them so needlessly with my rifle fire. If only I had listened to them from the beginning, instead of initiating violence. But thankfully, they bear me no grudge over their fawn. They feel no such emotions as spite, malice or revenge. In fact, the Migo have never willfully harmed any peaceful human, as I have learned. They are actually unjustly targeted by a cruel cult of humans who hunt and kill them on behalf of monstrous powers from other dimensions. It was these, the true villains, who stole the Blackstone and interfered with our communication in order to foment a fear of the Migo. Were we to have revealed their colony to this cult or to other humans, the outcome would have been catastrophic. It was only knowing the damage this cult might have caused that the Migo chose to sacrifice themselves, and regrettably, those of my dogs which were killed in order to achieve communication with me and avoid a greater harm to humanity and to Earth at large. In reality, the Migo want closer intellectual ties with humanity. They have so much to teach us and to learn from us. To this end, they have chosen me, to be the primary human interpreter. You may think me mad, but I wish to share with you the magnitude of the opportunity with which I am presented. They have already learned much of the Migo race and the alien culture. Okay. They communicate telepathically with one another, but through a routine surgery they are able to synthesize human speech such as you have heard. They have mastered the discipline of surgery. Their science is far more advanced than ours, Wilmoth. They have answered many of my confusions concerning their anatomical composition Their bodies are composed of a fungoid material not found on Earth, and their command of nanotechnology, still unknown to our race, allows them to shield themselves from most techniques of human photography, and to destroy their own bodies at a whim, should the risk of capture arise. We have mentioned that these beings communicate with one another through a form of telepathy, yet this crude supernatural delegation does no justice to their ingenious method of conversation. They confer amongst themselves through the transmission of targeted electromagnetic waves human science would refer to as ultraviolet light. The aliens' sense organs must perceive in these telepathic waves immeasurably precise variance in frequency, which to the alien mind conveys conceptual information in such complex syntax as to express ideas, feelings, and concepts far beyond the scope of human imagination. It does not suffice to refer to it as merely language. It is for this reason that the creatures loathe sunlight, which to their senses is an overwhelming crash of static, making speech impossible. It is unbelievable, everything I have learned from them. There is so much more to tell, but it cannot be written in its entirety. You must come with me as soon as possible, so we may discuss these incredible things in person. My house is no longer besieged, I have no more need of the dogs. It is entirely safe here now, and I take pleasure in rescinding my earlier warnings and extending to you my earnest invitation. I wish so badly to share this joy of discovery with you. You need not tell anyone about this. These matters are far too important to share with prying ears. Bring your laptop and the history of our communications, as much as you still have. We will need all of it to retrace our steps and to put right the many misconceptions we formed regarding my new acquaintances. You can take the train to Battleboro. I will meet you at the station whenever you find convenient. We can drive back to the farmhouse together. Prepare yourself to stay as long as possible and for long nights of enlightening conversation. P.S. They have given me an incredible new device, which you will be amazed to see. I was at the TH is macht mich fertig hier. I was at first consumed with suspicion, convinced this message has not in fact been written by Henry Eagley, who had never been so careless with capitalization as this message demonstrated. Were the implications of my conclusion not so horrific, I might have laughed at the obviousness of the ruse. Yet many questions remained unanswered. Did the fantastically intelligent Migo expect me to believe such a trick? And if they did, should they expose such details of their anatomical composition and technology? Furthermore, Eagley had mentioned they meant to capture him alive. Reading and rereading the text, I came to feel a glimmer of hope that my friend still survived. Suddenly, I noticed a pattern in what appeared to be the mistakes in Eagley's typing. Okay. Days or night of their thought reality unjustly stole their primary light express aesthetic entirely house ears long. Yeah. Days or night of their thought reality unjustly stole their primary light express aesthetic entirety house ears long. Huh. Do not trust, please help. Okay. Cup. Kapitel 6. Okay, das ist, das war's dann schon wieder. Ist nicht viel passiert. Aber wir sind ein bisschen weiter in der Handlung. Dann bis zum nächsten Mal.